How's everybody doing? My name is Sweah Nadira Muhammad, and I inspire people to live out their dreams regardless of their disability. I believe that everybody in here should be able to enhance your life spiritually, mentally, financially. Raise your hand if you agree with me that your life should be enhanced. That's right. Well, I studied psychology and business for 5 years at the University of South Florida, and I received my BA degree in psychology. In all my life, I considered myself normal. I never had any disciplinary problems in school. I made good grades. So when the doctors told me I was diagnosed with the most debilitating mental disorder known in mental health, I denied it. I questioned their expertise. How can you go for 28 years of your life with no problems and then be diagnosed with a mental disorder? And I learned later there were warning signs. I have slurred speech. I have a family history of mental illness. And when I was 8 years old, I could hear music in my head. My mom told me that everybody can hear music in their head. So I thought that meant if you concentrate hard enough, you can hear music in your head like the radio's playing. So I concentrated hard, and I heard Madonna song in my head. I thought that was so amazing. I was only 8 years old. I had no idea that it had something to do with mental illness. And you may wonder what could be so traumatic that would cause me to develop a mental disorder. Well, I experienced what a lot of people experience: abuse as a child, loss of a job. Here I am trying to get married and find a job at the same time. I kept getting sicker and sicker. I started seeing faces everywhere, faces in the rugs, faces in the walls, faces in the sheets. And I knew, having a BA degree in psychology, that this was a warning sign of mental illness, but I still didn't put two and two together and say I definitely have a problem. So I'm at my fiance's house in Orlando, and I said, well, what if I can hear music in my head again like when I was 8 years old? So I concentrated hard, and I heard Tupac song, All Eyes on Me, in my head, and I was like, oh, that's so amazing. And I was watching television, and this is what a lot of people experience. I thought everything on the television was about me. And my fiance saw that I was acting weird, so he called up my mom, and she said, bring her to St. Petersburg. So only way there, I was seeing visions. Some were from God, some were just complete mental illness, and having revelations. And I get to the hospital, and the doctors sit me down, and they say, you have paranoid schizophrenia. And I'm like, whoa, no way possible. I'm normal. Normal people don't get mental illnesses. I have a college degree. There's no way possible. So I didn't take the medicine. I denied it. And I was hospitalized again. So I knew about chemical imbalances and that if you have a nervous breakdown, it takes 3 to 6 months for the chemicals in your brain to balance with medication. So I started taking the medicine for a few months. I had a good paying job. I didn't want to lose it. So I couldn't wake up for work. I was having tardies every day, coming in late. And so I stopped taking the medicine. And 2 years went by, and I had no problems. I was fine. And then I started getting sicker and sicker, started seeing faces in the sheets again, and started having migraines every day for 6 months straight. So I was hospitalized again, and the doctor sit me down, and they say, you have paranoid schizophrenia. I'm like, whoa, no way possible. I keep myself up, I'm normal, not me. So I refused to take the medicine. So I was hospitalized 3 more times. Now my family got sick of this, of me being hospitalized, so they took a picture of me at my worst. And I looked at that picture, and I saw what I saw in those textbooks. I knew I did need help. So I got enough courage to go to the pharmacy and get some medicine. And the pharmacy tech was looking at me like I was a lunatic. So I was so nervous, I didn't know what to do. So the pharmacist came behind the counter, and he sat down, and he held my hand, and he said, you're beautiful. You're mentally exhausted. There's nothing wrong with taking medicine. It's like you have diabetes or if you have heart problems. You'll be okay. So they saved my life. And I've been taking my medicine for 4 years now and haven't had no relapses. And if you're here and you experience some of what I've experienced and you don't have Medicare, you don't have Medicaid, you don't have insurance, you can always dial 211 and they'll direct you to someone that'll be able to assist you. And there's benefits to taking your medicine. I've been able to get my first book published. It's called Don't Call Me Crazy, I'm Just in Love. It's in all the libraries now. And it took me 2 years to get my books in the library, so I'm happy about that. And And my book is more than about a romance. It's more than about mental illness. I teach people in my book how to live out their dreams regardless of their disability. Raise your hand if you got dreams, goals that you want to accomplish in your life. Well, I have a lot of big dreams. And the fastest way to reach your dream, I found out, is to change yourself. So I've been working on myself. And I heard a quote from Biggie and Puffy that you can't change the world until you change yourself. And so I've learned things through trials and tribulations that I overcome and books that I've read that enabled me to reach some of my goals. And in my book, Don't Call Me Crazy, I'm Just in Love, I write those things for you so you can reach your goals. And for example, I teach people if you don't know what you want to do, start doing different activities and find something that you will do for free. If you will do it for free and you love it, it might be your calling. And I tell people, don't go out and tell everybody about your newfound dream, because 90% of Americans hate their jobs. So they're going to tell you won't be able to make it. You won't accomplish that dream. So I tell people in my book, keep it to yourself and tell people that's in the same field of study that you're in so they can help encourage you. And Oprah says that true courage is becoming the person you dream to be. So I want to enhance everybody's life. So please, I'm in the back of the room. Please come by and pick up a book. And I'm giving free copies to the first 20 people that sign up for a free copy of my ebook, Don't Call Me Crazy, the sequel, because I finished the second book. Thank you.